All right, so in reviewing, just catching up, what we're going to do is try to start, we're going to make like a little mini progression, E minor in the green to the yellow, which is root, and then we're just going to switch charts, either on the same note, because they're lined up, see, 3, 3, 3, 5, 5, 5, they're just different colors, representing different modes, right? Now we can either stay on the same note or go to the next note next to it. So a mini progression would be like E minor to C to C to G. Okay, so it'd be E minor would be like where we were, right around here. I was saying we could start in E minor from the third string. Back to the E minor. Then we could hit that D minor we were talking about, which is in the purple, which is right here. So where are we? We're on this 5 here. Right on the bar. There's you see this big long green thing here? I continued it down there for a reason, but then I covered it with this. That's the big fret note. So we're right on that 5 there. That would be your open string. You want to get into a Dorian from there. We're going like. So it'd be like 5. You could just take it down into that Dorian purple zone. That 5 right there, back to that Dorian 2, so we could go down from there. Now let's just do a nice minor third on the same string, and then back up to the 5. Now we could take it to a G. Okay, so we want da, 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 da. We probably went to this. You know, we probably did that kind of thing. So let's see, we start here again on the E in the middle. Okay, we'll go from the 5. This one, I'm not sure what. Okay, we're actually on this 5 down here because we're in this G thing. Okay, so we can do a little G tic tac toe there. All right, so now we've done this. Effectively, we're on this 2. Now we want to take that 2 to the D minor. So we're going to go up to this 4, right? Now we're in F, so we can go, okay, from here, from F down to D minor. So we are on this root now, and we want to get to this 2. We'll probably go to this 6. Okay, it wants to go back to the G. All right, so that's what we did. Went to F. So it's hard, you know, it's hard to remember. I'd have to kind of write down where we're at. But you get the main point. And that's a nice progression. You know, that's not a bad progression. You know, if I played it in just blatant bar chords, it would sound like this. It doesn't sound as nice as if I, you know, as if we did it in piano, it'd be something like. suspend it. So, remember one thing, if you stay on all the white keys in the key of C on a piano, you're okay. You're not going to go out of key. So you can suspend the you can suspend the G, because the G, okay, in the key of G, this 7, when we suspend it, we're still on a play note, you see? So we can do that. Just caught it on the other string. So that's fun. You know, I mean, that's something that I wanted to show you yesterday. The other thing about this chart, now we gotta talk about it. So that's the fun part about the 3 charts, is you just find the note you're at, where do I want to go from there? And it's even better if you decide a progression. And then, so you know, if your progression goes D minor to G, right, which is something like that, you can start in your D minor zone, which is the Dorian is the D minor 2-4-6. Do whatever you're going to do in these purple notes here. And when you want to go to the G, say you're on this 6 and you don't know where to go, just go down to this 6 on the G. This is the Mixolydian one. See, the Mixolydian one is the G one. 5-7-2. That's your G. G, B, D. So, whatever note we stop on, the 6 here on the Dorian, we find the 6 down here, because they're lined up. And you find, guess what? That's not exactly in the G arpeggio, but you can take it right down to the G from there. Right, so if you just do a little Dorian arpeggio, okay, so now you're on the 6 here, you want to take it somewhere, where are you going to go? You're going to go to that 5, so it's going to go. All right, now you're on this 5, how do I get back to Dorian? That 3. There's no reason why you couldn't. So it'd be something like where were we, Dorian? Yeah, so you could use the charts to kind of get your way around, write a little song for yourself, see how it plays, and then maybe do the chords. But what's important about this chart, and the reason why I brought it up, it's the same thing that we were looking at before with the arpeggios, okay, except this has all 3 arpeggios. So this has starting with first inversion, has root, it has first inversion arpeggio, and second inversion arpeggio, okay? So second inversion arpeggio starts on G and ends on G. Okay, G is the 5th right here. Starts on G. And it should end on G. Here it is. 1, 2, 3, 5, root 3, 5, root 3. Now, it didn't end on G. What happened? Sorry, my bad. They don't end on the same note. The same note is straight up. They are a duplication of the same arpeggio inversion, so it's 5 root 3, 5 root 3. Okay, so that's what this chart is. But then we have the minors here, and we've added in this D minor to the Dorian. The yellow Aeolian does not have a minor associated with it. That's read it straight off the chart, C shaped.